It's Rebecca. Thanks so much for joining me for today's video. Today's video is going to be my next update. I forget what number this is for my Partners in Cream Project pen. I hope the girls don't mind that I'm filming this a little bit earlier, but I do have quite a bit of products finished. So I was just excited to add new products so I could get that momentum, keep that momentum going. I don't know what's wrong with my voice. It's been coming and going. I just filmed another video earlier today, and it keeps doing that. I don't know what's wrong with it. I feel fine, but just FYI, if I sound a little funky, that's why. So let's get started. This is a project in which we are trying to use up just cream products in our, as part of the project. And I'm working on 4 items. It's just the number that's been working for me. And I'm very excited to share with you guys that I finished 2 of the 4. So I'm going to start with those first. I finished this primer from Cover FX. This is a mattifying primer. It's supposed to have salicylic acid. Let me show you. Last update, I was right here and I finished it. It seems that I used exactly half of the product 1 month and the other half the next month. But I noticed that this doesn't really keep me matte. This actually, I feel like this breaks down my foundation. I'm using the Hydra Gel, Empowered Hydra Gel Foundation from Tarte. And I feel like when I use this, I had to really mix it here in the packaging, because if I just try to put it onto my fingers and apply it, oil would come out first and then the primer. So I had to really mix in here. It's probably because it's an old product. I wasn't too impressed though, so I don't think I would repurchase. And the other item that I finished was very exciting, my color tattoo. This is the 24, the Back to the Bronze color tattoo from Maybelline. And you guys, I have finished all of it. I am super excited. I use this every single day starting in November, I think. It wasn't brand new when I started this project, but I used it every single day as a base for my eyeshadows. No matter what color of eyeshadow I was wearing, I was always wearing this underneath, and I loved it. I think it's a great product. I kind of want to go buy more. This was my last color tattoo in my collection. I no longer have any, but I do have quite a few cream shadow sticks that I should probably get use out of before I go and buy more color tattoos. I loved it till the end. I never had to revive it or anything like that. I never had trouble with it. I really enjoyed it. I recommend the color tattoos if they still make them. I think they're good. And the next 2 items that I'm working on, I do have progress on them. The next one is this Marc Jacobs Remarkable Concealer. And I hope you guys can see, I have kind of started making my way down this way on the container, and then I was able to clear side of the jar here. So I'm very excited about that. I use this concealer every single day. It's super creamy. It doesn't, at least with the powder that I wear, it doesn't leave me looking dry and cakey under my eye. I really enjoy it. It's a great concealer. I bought this on a whim at Marshall's. The color happened to fit me. So I got really, really lucky with that. I love it. If it's still available, I would highly recommend. And then the item that I added last month is the LA Girl Pro Concealer. It's an HD concealer, but I'm using it as a cream bronzer. I don't know if you guys can see. I'll try to insert a picture or something so you guys can see, but I am down to right there. So down to right here, I was, last update, you could see a little bit of through the tube here, but now you can actually see the whole thing. I'm gonna have to insert a picture so you guys can see. But yeah, I am just down to here. This is all clear. It doesn't look clear to you guys, but it's clear to me. And so my product is from here to here. I use it every single day. I apply some here and here, and then right under my jawbone. No, not my jaw, my cheek, my cheekbone. And then I blend it out and I set it with a powder bronzer. So I am wearing it today. I think it looks good. I'm making it work. It's gonna last me a while as well, but I'm enjoying it. I'm glad I'm getting use out of it. So since I have 2 finished, I need to add 2 more. And the first one that I'm finishing is kind of the same as a color tattoo, but I really, I have this cream eyeshadow stick from Mali. This is in the color Subtle Shimmer. And this is a super old product. And unfortunately, this is broken. So it's broken from the base. It does feel a little bit dry when I already started playing with this one. I haven't marked it, so I will mark it. But just to give you guys a frame of reference, kind of, sort of, this is where I'm at right now. I will mark it with a marker on the cap. But when I apply it, because it's detached from the base, it does feel a little bit dry. It doesn't glide on as smoothly. So I was thinking about using another different color, but because this one's broken and kind of seems like it's drying off, I figured I should use this one first. So that's what I'm gonna do. And the next item that I finished that I'm going to add is this Essence Clear Brow Gel. This is almost brand new. I've used it a couple of times, but I don't think I've used this much product, but I will be marking it. My starting point will be like right about there, and we'll see how long it takes me to use this. My favorite one is the Anastasia Beverly Hills. I think that's the best, but Essence seems to have pretty good eyebrow products, so I'm gonna give this a go, and if I like it, maybe I'll find something that's a lot cheaper to repurchase than the ABH one. So that's it, and that is it, guys. That is my update for my Partners in Cream. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys are doing good progress with your items. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.